Hey guys, this is Big Kid here, archersfriend.com, bigkidreviews.com, and getadomaintoday.com, among many others. The link's down in the description if you want to check some others out. Today we're going to do a review and a installation video for the Trac Pontoon electric anchor winch. Now, we got a pontoon boat, and really the making of the anchor work, we're throwing it by hand, and then the cleats are up front. We'll get video clips of that later. And very impractical because our guard fence is in front of the front fishing chairs. I insisted on that to keep me and the grandkids and the other kids from falling out of the thing while you're fishing. So looked and looked and looked, and winches are god awful expensive, and I found this one at a quite reasonable price compared to others. It ain't cheap, but it's not bad. It also has a wireless remote switch available. They have a hardwire switch for a remote switch. I do not recommend that. They're usually out everywhere you check. But my goodness, you have cables out the wazoo running everywhere. And I recommend I think I paid about $50 extra for the wireless remote, and it's well worth it. Haven't got it operational yet. I'm just gonna make a video here of showing you all the ins and outs, because as usual, the instructions are written by somebody in another country, most likely, poor command of English. Pictures, they have 75% white space and foreign language on the instructions, instead of just printing the damn thing in English and taking up more space so that you can actually see it. Anyway, this is the pontoon model. Now on the picture you can see it's quite obviously mounted toward the back of a boat with lots of deck space. I don't know, on the corner, most of them on this side of it anyway, on the right hand side as you're going forward, there's usually a cut across and a ladder, but I don't even see the ladder platform on this one, so hard to say what they had in mind. But I want to point out something here. This part is an optional part here where it sucks up the anchor, then this actually lifts up, but it shows this guard in place. Now, on the one I've got, which is the 35 model, it is impossible to use that, and I'll show you. Okay, this is actually the one I've got, and I had to take off the cover, and we'll show you how to modify all the switches and stuff also. But as you can see, as the anchor comes up and hits that, it raises up a little bit. And I couldn't even mount this on there with this guard in place. Now, true story, this is a pinch point. If somebody's in there or something is in there and it winches up, yeah, that's a lot of torque and pressure. It's going to get somebody hurt. Now, after this roller assembly is installed, you try to put this back on here, and you might get away with fastening just the top screw, but you cannot fasten both of them. And as you go up, you see that piece is moving. So it's some kind of a design flaw, design issue. I'll probably just leave it off. I don't know yet. If I try to mount it just to the top screw, there's no way in hell the bottom one's gonna mount, because this crossbar right there is preventing it from attaching to the bottom screw. If I put it here with just the top screw and put it loose, I can maybe get it to work. But I don't know. I'll try that. But as it comes up, it hits this and it may jam it. I'd rather have the freedom of movement of this. So with that being said, we'll move on out to the boat and show the options of where to put it and how come I had to re-engineer and redesign a mounting bracket for it.